hardcore pornography. But I must admit it fascinated me always. You know why? Because it's maybe the most paradoxical genre that you can imagine. On the one hand is, ooh, we see everything, you know. Yes, we see everything, but at the same time, A, it's the most codified genre that you can imagine. I know because I saw a good friend's documentary on, not the making of Psycho Vertigo, but the making of a hardcore movie, where they see how, again, how absolutely codified it is. For example, the standard heterosexual hardcore movie. You know, you present the two people, first you have masturbation, dreaming about each other, then the big act, first cunnilingus. It's absolutely codified. Then, now I will tell you something that may shock you. Dean McConnell, a Californian friend of mine, I lost contact of him now, wrote a wonderful analysis of, it's disgusting, I warn you, but it's wonderful, of the expressions of women's face during sexual act in hardcore movies. And he discovered there is nothing spontaneous about it. It's strictly codified, even a kind of a Gramscian semiotic square, four expressions are codified. And then I learned from people who are doing these movies that it's, they even have, I forgot them, terms about them. One is the one you would have expected, the ecstasies. More, whatever. Then things get much more interesting. The next expression is what I'm tempted to call, in Habermasian terms, the instrumental reason expression. It's, you know, the woman with her lips tight, looking down, like, oh my God, one another effort. It's hard work. You know, this, we are in the middle of hard work. The third expression is indifference. Woman is chewing gum, don't. And this is part of erotic play. A true femme fatale must play indifference, you know. And then the last one, this is the third one, indifference. The last one, which is the most dangerous one, it's also absolutely codified, is while the man is doing the hard work, the woman is looking at him with an ironic smile, like, haha, is this all you can do, or whatever, you know. So you see, even there, the intimate domain, it's a perfectly structured semantic series of oppositions and so on. But so you think you see everything directly. No, I developed long ago this point. You pay the price. It's heavy censored. It was like this, and even now it is in the majority of hardcore movies. You know, I'm sorry if you know this story, but I think it holds. This example of mine. I remember when I was young in my adolescence, big experience, the first hardcore movies. What shocked me is how utterly, I'm talking about this long, 1.5 hour full movie, how utterly stupid the story is. You know, they had to use a story. I was so shocked, you know, it's extreme vulgarity. Like I remember once, how do you call it, the guy who regulates water supply, who does pipes and so on. Plumber, sorry. A plumber fixes the kitchen and then the housewife comes to him and says, okay, you fixed that hole, but I have another hole to be fixed. Can you, you know, like you are just embarrassed. And then it got to me. They are not so stupid. The price you pay for it, for seeing all, is that it must be sabotaged at the psychological level. It must be, it is as if to have both of it, authentic investment and direct hardcore sex, it wouldn't work. It's Lacanian well of castration, well, choice at its purest. You can see it all, but chop, chop, you will not get serious emotions. faked, but to be taken as serious. The proof is another one. I know Catherine Breillat and so on. There is a whole series of directors today who try to do this, to do a serious melodrama, even psychological drama, but it's typical how it doesn't catch on. How it remains marginal. Now you will say, but as I was brutally said at some point, but listen, you must be pretty old because this type of movies, Plumberer, are no longer made for 20, 30 years, no? And then I asked them, but what is going on? And they told me Gonzo movies, which are even worse censorship. You notice in Gonzo movies, the definition is, I think, that actors don't even pretend that they are part of a narrative. Gonzo means actors themselves, while doing its sex, directly address camera and refer to it. You know, all this irony. Am I good now? Should I move my leg like that? I think this is an even worse censorship. It is that you have to get the message all the time, we are not acting seriously, and so on and so on. So you see, this is how we should correct that notion about directness. Sometimes directness, in this sense, okay, we think about sex, but we show it all, is the most obfuscating thing that there is.